Hello everybody, Dad is here. As I promised you, it's the next day. I'm start building water cooling portion of the build. Originally I planned to finish it up and make you kind of overview, but I decided to try at least to make little filming in the process. And if it looks good, I'll give you that video. If not, I will do overview. So far, where I am. First of all, you can see that I have to work on this radiator area with connecting it to CPU and this reservoir. And I really love that this old and discontinued case is still so much convenient in terms of panels is removable. I can't really remove them, but at least I can slide them. So that's open all this easy access to all the parts I need. So it's such a beautiful case. I think that Silverstone might want to look on it and maybe make upgraded version, like Cosmos was basically reinvented. So this is one of the good examples of the products that shouldn't be discontinued, in my personal opinion. So anyways, so I slept on a subject of flexible tubing versus hard tubing. I considered ZMT rubber tube, which I never use, and I thought like black tubing wouldn't be look terribly bad in this particular mod, if you will. But I decided that I will stick to the hard tube and will use the shiny copper tubing, which is looks really awesome. I came in the morning, look on few pieces that I put in place just to have some idea, and I feel that yes, it looks as I like. I like it yesterday, I like it today, so that's good proof that I'm on the right path. So one thing that I would like to talk is specifically about this copper tube. I actually was told in the past by Mod My Mods guys, who also has a store in States, and they told me that, listen, you should try copper tubing. It's like really cool. You might really like it. And I never had a chance to do that. And almost like a year later, now I'm working with this tube, and I can tell you that I really like it. That's true. I might be start using it much more than I used before. It has some big pluses and couple minuses. So I would like to talk about this for a second. Also, it's not related to my build, but I think it's everybody will be interested in that particular observation that I did. So I think the copper tube is kind of between acrylic and the PETG. Why I'm saying that is the fact that copper tube cutting process is so much easier because you can use the like, proper rotary tool, so it's easy cut as PETG, right? And if you make a little mistake, it's also easy to cut additional piece, so it's not a biggie. Unlike acrylic, which you have to saw and have a lot of work around and you rush a little bit, might crack, so this in terms of preparing bits and pieces, this is absolutely awesome material. The disadvantage of it is that you can't really bend most of the product on the market. I think there's certain like pure copper tubing which is not hardened, you still can't bend, but most of stuff that's sold in computer stores, including myself, and that was available for me, which is nickel plated, it look awesome in different colors, that most likely you cannot bend it. It either will snap completely, just break, or all this plating will chip off and you basically, yeah, it looks like crap, you don't want it either. So if you're okay with not bending, I wholeheartedly recommend to try copper tubing. I also give you a tip how to avoid additional costs. So how I do it in my particular case, because I also don't want to use like 10 meters of tubing, make a little mistake. So I using cheap PETG that costs like next to nothing comparing with metal one, and I make an exact piece that I need first. So before I cut my piece that in the metal, I actually fiddle with PETG, which very easy to work. You can easily like make it like shorter if you need to, and then I cut exactly what I need in the metal. So it's a good cost saving tip, believe me, because you make mistakes like from time to time, sometimes all the time, and like spending few dollars on PETGs, just goes in the garbage in the end, and cut exact lengths for the copper, it will save you time. Another thing that I like about copper tubing is that it's really easy to work out all imperfections. So this still will not work. So I always actually hate it. Everybody uses it, everybody's selling it, but realistically it's a piece of junk, right? But it works, but not perfect. So for this one, I just have to use the filer, essentially. And it's such easy to make a really smooth, sloped edge. It goes into the fitting beautifully, no cutting, oring, nothing. So I absolutely like how it's working out for me. Bottom line, guys, I do my first experience, as you can see, with this copper tube. It looks awesome, easy to work with, no problem with thermal problems, because PETG has a low melting point, and I have a few customers who lost their rigs completely. They get too hot, tube deforms, start leaking, kill like $2,000 GPU or couple, not fun. So this one, you can boil liquid in it, nothing will happen. Hopefully it's not the case, because now you have other problems, but nevertheless. So it's absolutely perfect material, fully compatible with all the other copper stuff, no problem with cutting, no problem with temperatures. Wow, this is a lot of pros to go this route. So I recommend you. Another thing that I would like to mention, that I really continue to be amazed how good this case is. It's discontinued old case, but because of all the modularity, it makes things so much easier. Like, look, I have need the access to this radiator points, which is kind of hard to insert tubing in and put fitting in place. And I just disconnected my side panels for 525 devices. So now I have a full access to everything that I need. No stress, easy to work. I also figure out position of reservoir, which not interfere with any optical drive, nothing like this. So I will have to drill three holes basically, because one already in place. I drill three holes, fix it with bolts, so it will be like solidly in place. So that part is easy. And I have one port which will be draining port. Here I will have my filling port and port for allow air get in when you're draining the system, because if you don't have a place where the air coming in, it's not going to drain. We discussed it in a different video. So you see, guys, it's going pretty good. Right now I'm going to stop filming and we'll continue finishing my loop, see how it looks, and after that, when the loop is done, I will just remove everything, drill my holes, I will repaint a couple places which I scratched, because my painting is not like power coating, so you do little mistakes and it gets scratched, so I would like to repaint that. Also potentially thinking that I probably will put a filter temporary, and I'll catch whatever like debris potentially can be in the system, and then when it's done, I drain it and finish loop without filter, because keeping filter all the time makes no sense, but in the beginning it has a lot of sense. It's always some little debris stuck in the radiator and that get washed over the few hours of work, or you have a little piece of rings that get cut with the hard tubing, so it's always something, and you don't want to stuck it in your CPU block, because microfins in a heat killer product specifically, they're really small. And I already had a bad experience, and my flow rate just dropped dramatically, and it wasn't much fun. And basically what I end up was draining and cleaning it. So no, just a good idea to fix it by filter, for example, in advance. All right, guys, so that's it for now. Work it out and come back in a few seconds to tell you where I am further down the road.